We've had a few requests on how to paint the fiery glow on the Herdstone, so in today's video we're going to show you how to do that. Now the colours we're going to be using, we're going to start with Mephiston Red, which we'll use to dry brush around the fireplace, but we'll also use a nice fine brush and pick out all those carved runes as well. Then we're going to move on to Troll Slayer Orange, again dry brushing around the fireplace, and maybe just a few little highlights or running into the recesses around the eyes and some of the runes as well. And finally we'll use Avalon Sunset just around the fireplace and the fire itself. So starting with Mephiston Red, I'm just going to use a small dry brush for this. I'm just going to apply a little bit onto my palette just to load up the brush, and then I'm just going to start wiping it off. And once I've done that, I'm not going to wipe too much off because I want this to be quite heavy actually. So what we're going to do is just going to concentrate around this area. So I'm just going to go right at the back, around the actual fire, and also we'll do the fire as well. So you can base coat this if you wish to, or you can just run straight in there and do a heavy dry brush. The key areas really are the fireplace itself to get this nice glow effect. And what you need to do as you work out is actually put some of the red around the black that we painted in the other video. With the fireplace now dry brush, we're going to use Mephiston Red. And what we're going to do here is just going to pick out the eyes themselves. Again, you can just run that right inside. Just wipe your finger on the outside like so. And then also just by thinning it down with a touch of water, just means it runs into all these runes a lot easier. And if you do like splodge on the top, you can just wipe it with your finger. It will just remain in the recesses. And actually you might get a little bit of transfer on the top, but that will look like glow, so that's quite cool. With the runes and eyes now picked out on Mephiston Red, what we're going to do now is use Troll Slayer Orange. We're just going to start around the fireplace and I'm going to start dry brushing again. Now here, I'm actually going to leave some of the red showing. So I'm just going to move a bit further back from the red dry brushing I did. But actually when you get into the deep bits at the back of the actual fireplace, then obviously you'll just want to try and get as much of that done as possible, just leaving some of the Mephiston Red in the recesses. And of course, when you start dry brushing the fire, even Mephiston Red in the recesses. And you might want to do a couple of coats of Troll Slayer Orange when you do this, just to help brighten it up. With the Troll Slayer dry brush now done, we're just going to use a medium layer brush. I'm just going to run it into some of the recesses, like around the eyes, like so. And if there's any like deep sort of carvings and stuff like that, you can just run it into there as well. You don't have to go too mad, don't do all of them. Just a couple here and there. With the glow on the eyes and some of the runes, what we're going to do now is use Avalanche Sunset, and we're just going to start dry brushing like a final highlight around some of the rocks. Obviously you want to keep some of that Troll Slayer Orange and Mephiston Red showing, just to give a little bit of gradients. And obviously we'll just work a bit top, higher up where the flames are as well, just to give it that nice fiery feel. And there we are, with that dry brush now done, the fiery effect is finished. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. Keep sending those requests in and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.